Well, it's the $5 billion industry that's changed our love lives forever. Online dating accounts for more than 25% of new relationships, and that number is set to rise in the coming years.
Globally, millions of singles take to their smartphones and computers to find their perfect match. And in the lead-up to Valentine's Day, the last few weeks have been the peak period for online dating. It is all going on. So, how will dating evolve in the next 10, 20 or 30 years? Let's ask futurist Chris Riddell, who joins us live now from Melbourne. G'day, Chris.
Hi, G'day, Larry.
Now, mate, we just mentioned that a quarter of new relationships are formed online. So how many couples are projected to meet on the internet in the next 20 years? That's if the internet is even still around. I have my doubts.
Look, the internet is changing everything that we do, and the statistics are absolutely mind-blowing. Research is actually telling us that by the year 2031, more than 50% of us will meet new relationships for the first time online.
Wow.
Oh, wow. And then what happens from there? How else does it evolve?
The evolution of online is that we're just going to continue to become more mobile. It's going to happen more transparently and more frictionless behind the scenes. So you won't have these separate apps going ahead in the future. You're going to have these integrated into your existing social network. So if you imagine that you're in a bar and you're single and somebody else is in that bar, the apps will automatically notify you in the background and match you up. And then you've got an opportunity to go and connect in real life.
Oh, so you can actually go have a look at them across the bar and decide if you're going to go to the other side of the bar. Yeah, it's good.
Absolutely.
50 Shades of Tinder. Hey, we're already seeing new technologies helping people find the perfect match. Now, there's an app that optimizes your chances, right?
There is. There's this app called PPL KPR. Don't know why it's quite being called that, but hey. And what the app does is it actually, you have this wristband, you put it on and it detects your mood. It then connects to your social networks and finds people that you should or should not connect with in that day. So if you've lost the ability to be able to use your own human emotions and think of who you should or shouldn't speak to, then this app and device can do it for you and put you with people that you should be speaking to.
That bracelet looks so ugly that I don't think I would talk to somebody on the basis of wearing an ugly bracelet in the first place.
That's right. And be warned, it looks very similar to a house arrest bracelet.
I'm so making a fashion judgment first. DNA profiling, that's starting to be used. I mean,
we are.
I guess you've always swapped DNA, but that's
later.
Further down the track.
That's after you've swiped.
How does that happen at the beginning of a relationship?
It does. So there's this website. It actually started off over in the US. It's called 23andme.com. And what you can do is you log on to the website. They'll send you a test tube. You spit into it. You send it back to them. And they'll actually give you a DNA profile and tell you what future diseases you may or may not have. If you think about this in the context of a relationship, what you could actually do is look for your perfect partner and actually DNA profile them before you agree to even get married. It's a scary thought.
So can you put your potential partner that you're looking at online in a test tube and check them for potential diseases? I think that's important.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Virtual girlfriend technology is also in development, right? This sounds
encouraging.
Encouraging. Tell us about this one.
Look, for those of us that can't go out into the real world or are really struggling for that interpersonal communication, the movie Her that we're just seeing now, that came out not that long ago, and it's actually the whole Siri-based relationship. So software is getting more intelligent day by day, and it's actually predicted that going ahead, software will actually be able to mimic moods just like humans. So you could have a relationship with a software-based system going ahead in your life.
I quite like Siri.
I think she's single.
How will
marriage change in the future? That's how this dating's changed. Yeah. What about marriage?
This one's really bizarre, Kylie. This one looks really, really quite strange going ahead.
Because like putting a DNA in the mail isn't strange, but anyway, what's this one?
This one goes even to the more extreme. Marriages in the future are actually going to be more predicted to be based around fixed-term contracts. So 2, 3, 5, 10 years, you'll go into a marriage, you'll agree how long that you will go into that marriage for, and at the end of that term, you'd actually then to look to renew or walk away and in your own separate ways. It's no different to a driving license. You renew your driving license every 3 or 5 years. Why can't you do the same with a marriage?
You've got to have your eyes checked too when you're going for this again. Hey, that is absolutely fascinating. Thank you very much for joining us this morning.
Thank Pleasure. You. Thanks very much, guys. Look forward to it.
Do you know my big thing about that is that everybody's in the bar, you're all checking your apps to see if this app's going to talk to this app.
In the discotheque.
And in the meantime, you're missing the cute guy over there who might be like looking to, you know, catch your eye. Everyone's too busy doing this.
No, because he'd be swiping.
And not just sort of looking around.
He'd be swiping you from behind.
Because
if he thought you were, if you were in his, you know, zone, then he would have swiped you by now anyway. If he's not looking your way, then that's because he doesn't like you or finds you attractive with your bracelet.
That, you know, that thing that you can't put in a phone.
What is it? It's not Sound of Music, Kylie.
I'm just saying.
It's a real world.